have an uncommitted superdelegate from the upcoming critical state of North Carolina with us. David Parker, we thank you for being here today.
American Morning, the most news in the morning.
What is it for you? Is it a sense of who is the most electable? Is it a sense of who I'm most comfortable with?
No, it's not a comfort level. I'm very comfortable with either one of them. I think both of them will make outstanding presidents.
So how do you determine which one is most electable?
I'm looking to see who's the most persuasive on the economy.
The Democratic presidential candidates still running neck and neck. The race could, as you probably know by now, come down to being decided by something called a superdelegate, a whole bunch of them. And David Parker, for you, I know you have been involved in the DNC before as well. How do you go forward deciding? I understand you've been getting bombarded with emails and phone calls.
Well, it's interesting. Just about everybody I talk to who finds out I'm a superdelegate has got an opinion. The gal that was putting powder on my face just a minute ago told me what she thought, and she had a pretty good idea.
What are you looking for from either one of the candidates before you throw your support behind them?
Electability nationwide, and looking at the down ballot races, we've got a U.S. Senate race here in North Carolina that I'm very concerned about.
But I'll also be looking at what impact it'll have on down ballot races in North Carolina, mm-hmm. particularly across the South. And one of the things that I'm looking at as a North Carolina resident and Democratic activist is how well will Democrats do down ballot? For instance, we have a U.S. Senate race that's mm-hmm. up in North Carolina. Which candidate will help our candidate beat Elizabeth Dole?
What about this whole idea of if you don't make up your mind soon, there's a chance that the Democrats could go into this convention divided and that will be a disaster?
You know, Franklin Roosevelt did not win on the first ballot in 1932, and there's historical precedent for this. Barack Obama has not gone through a tough campaign in a primary before, and for that matter, not in a general election. Doing a little sparring with Hillary Clinton, who is an incredibly tough competitor and may in fact knock him out, is good training for him in the fall. John McCain is not going to pull any punches, and that those gloves are going to come off quickly.
As more superdelegates board his bandwagon on this final day of what has been a very long and heated primary race. Well, it's my understanding that you have said you're not going to announce your decision until after 10:30 tonight. Is that right?
Sometime between 10 and 10:30. I want to wait till those polls closed. I made my pledge that I would wait that long, and I wanted to see this run out.
Well, David Parker, an uncommitted superdelegate still after all this time. I guess we'll wait and see what your decision is a little bit later on. Unless
yes,
you'd like to announce it right now.
Well, I appreciate the offer. You're very kind.
Well, full of those southern manners there from North Carolina. David Parker, thank you.
I think everybody ought to be a superdelegate and feel what I feel.
Howard Dean would have kittens if he did that.
Well, maybe that would do him some good. I don't know.
All right. David Parker, undecided superdelegate from North Carolina. Good to have you on this morning, sir. Thanks.
Good to be here. You take care.